Mentalista at public service program. Ito lamang simpila ng DWPL.
The preceding program expresses only the opinions and views of its respective block timer, producer, radio announcer, writer, and production staff, and does not in any way reflect the views of this station. The station has advised the programmers to abide by broadcast laws and KBP rules.
Hope is one of the most powerful words in any language. No matter how difficult your situation in life, if you have hope, you can make it. But in a country or situation like ours, where life is getting more difficult, where can we find real hope? Stay with us and find the answer on A Word of Hope with Bishop David Sobrepeña. Dr. Emil Brunner, a Swiss theologian, says, "What oxygen is for the lungs, such is hope for the meaning of human life." The Bible in Hebrews chapter 6, verse 18 tells us to lay hold upon the hope set before us. Today, Bishop David Sobrepeña urges us to hold on to our hope.
Let me read to you from Hebrews chapter 6, verse 18 to 19. Here's what it says, that by two immutable things, in which it is impossible for God to lie, we might have strong consolation who have fled for refuge to lay hold of the hope set before us. This hope we have as an anchor for the soul, both sure and steadfast, and which enters the presence of the veil. Another passage from 1 Peter chapter 1, verse 3 says, "Blessed be the God and Father of our Lord Jesus Christ, who according to his abundant mercy has begotten us again to a living hope through the resurrection of our Lord Jesus Christ." Hope is so important, so needed in this world in which we live today. And I'm sure there are people now that are feeling that they are hopeless. I'm sure that in the hearts and in the lives of many, there is desperation to be free, to get out of this. In fact, napakarami na po na mga theories. Marami na pong mga nababasa natin, nakikita natin sa internet, mga hindi ka nice-nice na mga news. There are a lot of fake news. There are a lot of conspiracy theories, or some are believable. But actually, in a day like today, the news are so convoluted that you don't know who to believe. But I want you to believe what the Bible says, because the Word of God is the sure Word of God. And hope is the surest thing that God wants to put in the hearts of each one of us. You know, according to a writer by the name of Dr. Emil Brunner, what oxygen is for the lungs, such is hope for the meaning of human life. How true that is. People are becoming hopeless. You know, they resort to suicide and doing desperate things. But I'd like for us to look into what God tells us about this hope that we have in our living Lord. The Bible tells us to lay hold upon the hope set before us. Now, why is hope so important? Why is hope, you know, like an oxygen to our soul, to our spirit in this world in which we live in? Number one, hope gives us courage in the midst of adversities. In 1 Peter chapter 1, verse 6 to 7, the Apostle Peter said, "In this you greatly rejoice, though now for a little while, if need be, you have been grieved by various trials." And what is God's purpose? So that the genuineness of our faith, which is more precious than gold that perishes, though it is tested by fire, may be found to praise, honor, and glory at the revelation of Jesus Christ. See, hope gives us courage in the midst of adversities. Oh, there are so many things that are happening. You know, can you just imagine the feeling of many Christians around the world, even here in the Philippines? Yung mga adversities na dinadaanan na mga maraming kapatiran natin, mga pastors, mga Christian leaders. And it is unimaginable. This has not happened before. Brothers and sisters, I want you to pray with me so we can grapple, have great answers. Hope is a weapon that God has given you and me, glory to God, to cope with the things that are happening in our world today. Because hope gives us courage. We can rejoice in the midst of trials. There is an unusual verse in James chapter 1, verse 2. And in a time like this, it seems like out of place, but God's word is never out of place in our lives. Ito pong sinasabi ng salita ng Panginoon sa James 1, 2. My brethren, count it all joy when you fall into various trials. I could have joy in my heart for the right reason, for the hope that Jesus Christ is alive and that He gives me something great to look forward to. Glory to God. You cannot thank God for everything, but in everything, in whatever circumstances you are in, you can thank the Lord. Because God ultimately has everything in home. And because of hope, He gives us courage in the midst of trials. Oh, dami mga trials ngayon na naririnig ko sa ating mga kapatiran. Ang isa sa mga malaking trials, yung kawalan ng pera, yung pagkasira ng negosyo. Sabi nga nila, hindi na COVID-19 ang problema ko. FUBID-20, yung poverty. You know, we are in the same boat. But I want you to have courage in your heart. Ang nakapagbibigay sa atin ng courage ay ang salita ng Panginoon, ang ating pag-asa. Hope gives you courage to hold on. At kung ikaw ay nag-hold on sa Panginoon, hindi ka mangangawit, okay, na mahuhulog ka na. But He gives you the strength. Number two, why hold on to hope? Because hope drives you closer to God for answers. You know, there are many answers that they are giving us in the media. Some are conflicting. But let me tell you, I'd rather ask the Lord for answers. And yes, God gives you answers as you draw closer to Him. The Bible says, my sheep hears my voice and they follow me. At tayo po mga mananampalataya sa Panginoon. Yes, He can speak to us. Like a shepherd leading his flock, you can hear the still small voice of God. Someone who will not disappoint you. God will not disappoint you. It says in Romans chapter 5, verse 5, now hope does not disappoint. Because the love of God has been poured out in our hearts by the Holy Spirit who was given to us. Hope does not disappoint. Hindi ka bibiguin ng pag-asa natin na pinagkaloob ng Panginoon sa atin. Ang dami nating kabiguan ngayon sa mga nangyayari sa ating mundo. Let me tell you, the hope that you and I have in our hearts, if you have Jesus in your heart and in your life, it will not disappoint you. It says in Romans chapter 4, verse 18, the story of Abraham, how he got his miracle. You know the story? Abraham and Sarah are way too old to have a baby, to have a son. But God said to them, to Abraham, I will make you a great nation. So in Romans chapter 4, verse 18, it gives us a glimpse of what was happening in the heart of Abraham that paved the way for his miracle from God. And this is something that you and I should have to pave our way into God's miracle. Para matanggap natin yung himala ng Panginoon, matanggap natin yung mga pangako ng Diyos sa atin, yung kailangan natin sa Panginoon. Ano po sabi sa Romans chapter 4 verse 8? Who contrary to hope, in hope believed, so that he became the father of many nations, according to what was spoken, so shall your descendants be. I want you to underline what it says. Who contrary to hope, in hope believe. Aba, yung kanyang pinangahawakan na pag-asa na siya ay magkakaroon ng anak, sila ay magkakaroon ng anak na lalaki, and for the promise, the vision for him to be a father of nation is against hope. It was contrary to hope. What are you facing today? Maybe your business is shut. But you don't know what you're going to do in order to revive your business, in order to regain your job, regain your financial stability and prosperity that you had before COVID-19. Hallelujah. I'm sure some of you, this is not yet contrary to hope. But just in case you are in that boat, the Bible says, who contrary to hope, in hope believe. May pag-asa tayo. Kung kaya tayo dapat maniwala sa ating Diyos na gumagawa ng mga kababalaghan, we need to hang on to hope. Why? Number 3, hope directs our focus on our heavenly inheritance. Because hope has something to do with our future. When you are hoping for something, it's something that has not happened yet. But you're waiting for something to happen in the future. Some in the not too distant future. Others are 1 year from now, 2 years from now, as long as you're still alive. Some, like some of the promises of God, after we are gone from this earth. But I want you to hear what the Bible says. In 1 Peter chapter 1, verse 4, it says, to an inheritance incorruptible and undefiled, and that does not fade away, reserved in heaven for you. So hold on to our hope, because hope directs our focus to our heavenly inheritance. Glory to God. You know, do you know anything about inheritance? Some of us probably have inherited already several hectares of land from our parents who have passed away, from our grandparents. You have inherited maybe a business. You have inherited money. You know, there was this guy that I know. He works as a waiter in a restaurant. And he is not well schooled. And so one day, somebody looked for him as he told the story to me. Sabi niya sa akin, hinanap daw siya ng embassy ng United States ng halos isang taon. Mga sulat na pinapadala sa kanya ay bumabalik daw sa Amerika. So nag-research sila, nag-research. Kasi bago namatay yung uncle niya sa California, ay inilista siya na isa sa kanyang mga kamag-anak. His uncle was never married, he was single, but yet he has amassed some wealth, some real estate, and money in the bank. So to make the long story short, they discovered him working as a waiter sa isang restaurant. He told me he was invited to go to the U.S. Embassy to be told and provide documents, his birth certificates, etc., etc. And true enough, he was that same person, identical with what this uncle who passed away. So to make the long story short, he was hoping for months that this will be true. And it was true. He was able to inherit a big sum of money. In the same way, it has something to do with our future. Glory to God. Siguro ang iba sa inyo, sana ako rin, no? Sana ako rin. Let me tell you, The inheritance that God has prepared for us is so much greater than what money can buy. But of course, you know, it's handy. But just hang in there. Marami po mga sorpresa ang Panginoon para sa atin habang tayo nabubuhay. Can you say a big amen? Hindi po limitado ang magagawa ng Panginoon kung tayo ay umaasa sa Kanya. But the greatest rewards, inheritance, our blessings are prepared for us throughout all eternity. God has prepared an eternal riches and inheritance for us, my brothers and sisters. Oh, just look at it this way. You get to live, you know, an average na life expectancy dito sa mundo ngayon. If I remember it right, I read somewhere it's around 67. Yun ang average, tumaas na. Yun yung mga mortality rates ng mga insurance companies. So, let's just say that you get to live 75 or 85 or even 92 years old. It's still short compared to eternity. Meron nga akong kapatid na nakausap. Ilan taon na po kayo? 95 na po. Magna-96. Sabi ko, Lola, talagang kumain ka ng maraming gulay, kumain ka ng mga masasarap. Huwag masyado yung karne ng baboy at yung mga taba para maabot po ninyo yung 100 years. Kasi ang narinig ko, meron kayang 1 million na matatanggap kapag dumating kayo, natamo nyo ang 100 years. You're a centenarian. Talaga, Pastor? Oo. I don't know if most of us will reach that. I'll just be thanking the Lord if I reach 80 years old. But praise the Lord. God has great surprises for us throughout all eternity. There's eternal riches and inheritance for us. Number four, lastly, hold on to hope, because hope prepares our life for His return. All of this eternal inheritance will be triggered when Jesus Christ returns and take us to be with Him in heaven. Of course, right now, if you are a believer in Jesus Christ, yung eternal inheritance mo, nag-iipon na yan. You know, interest, araw-araw, every minute, every hour, every day that you are serving the Lord, you're praising the Lord, you're faithful to the Lord, doing this for God and for His kingdom, those rewards are compounding. Glory to God. Hallelujah. And as we are nearing the return of our Lord Jesus Christ, and I certainly believe that what is happening now in this world today with this COVID-19 pandemic is a dress rehearsal of the things that are going to happen in this world as we prepare for the end times, for the coming of our Lord Jesus Christ. Because the Bible tells us that those that can be shaken will be shaken. God is shaking things up in this world so that the unshakable will appear. And the only thing that cannot be shaken is the kingdom of God and our hope in the Lord. In 1 John chapter 3, verse 2-3, tells us, Beloved, now we are children of God, and it has not yet been revealed what we shall be, but we know that when He is revealed, we shall be like Him, for we shall see Him as He is. And everyone who has this hope in Him purifies himself, just as He is pure. So there are some practical results of a hope-filled life. Ano po itong mga practical results kung ang ating buhay ay punong-puno ng pag-asa? Number one, when I hold on to our hope, I can pursue God's dream for my life and work. Because of the hope that you have in you, these things are not lost. You know, there must be a diversion or just temporary setback. The second thing that will happen if you hang on to hope is this. I can cope with whatever problem and adversity that come my way. That's right. Yung mga iba sinabi na, oh, ang hirap-hirap naman. I don't know what I'm gonna do. And there are moments that we could doubt. There are moments that we worry. It's just but natural. We're all human beings. But in the end, if you have this hope, you can cope with whatever problem and adversity
that come your way. In 2 Corinthians chapter 4, verse 8 to 9, it says, we are hard pressed on every side, yet not crushed. We are perplexed, but not in despair. Persecuted, but not forsaken. Struck down, but not destroyed. Praise God. You can say with the Lord, we can make it, Lord. I can make it. You can make it with the Lord. I can do all things through Christ who gives me strength. So in 2 Corinthians chapter 4, verse 16, it says, therefore we do not lose heart, even though our outward man is perishing, yet the inward man is being renewed day by day. And then verse 17, it says, for our light affliction. Salamat tayo sa Panginoon. Wala tayong lagnat. Hindi ka tinamaan ng COVID-19. Salamat sa Panginoon na we are still alive. Can you say amen? Oh yes, bored. Some of you were so bored. Siguro bored na lang kayo sa mga pinapanood yung mga programa na sa inyong mga television. But seriously speaking, our light affliction, which is but for a moment, is working for us a far more exceeding and eternal weight of glory. Glory to God. Hallelujah. We can make it. We can make it as a church. You can make it as a Christian. You can make it as a professional. Whatever you do, you can make it because of the hope that you and I have in Jesus Christ. Then the third thing, a practical application to this is, I can say no to acts of desperation or despair. If you lay hold on hope, you could say no sa mga acts of desperation or despair. Tayong gagawa ng krimen, huwag tayong magnakaw, huwag tayong gagawa ng ganito. Sa mga desperado, say no to those acts of desperation and despair. Oh, in Psalm chapter 62, verse 5, it says, my soul waits silently for God alone, for my expectation is from Him. And so fourthly, if you hold on to our hope, if I hold on to my hope in Christ, I can take time to rest in the Lord. I can take time to rest in the Lord. One of the things that I do in order to be able to sleep, to drown out whatever worry I have, I just play an entire book of Genesis, Exodus, while I'm trying to sleep and listening to the Word of God and listening to the stories of the Bible until I'm already asleep. Glory to God. Or a Christian music, praise and worship. I can rest in the Lord, knowing that tomorrow is a better day. That is hope. It may be dark today, but tomorrow the sun will shine again. There may be problems in the world today. It may be even the end of the world. But tomorrow there will be new heavens and new earth that God has prepared for us. That is the Christian's hope, that we can hang on.
You alone are my rock and my salvation. You alone are my God. I will never tremble. I will never fear.
roar.
Though the mountains crumble and
the sea,
I will never tremble.
I will never fear. I know you will rescue me.
Though the earth may rumble,
though the ocean roar,
though the mountains crumble
and the sea,
I will never tremble.
I will never fear.
I believe that the Holy Spirit is speaking in your hearts this very moment about your need of Jesus Christ as personal Lord and Savior. I want you to pray this prayer sincerely. Sabihin mo, Lord Jesus, patawarin mo po ako sa aking mga kasalanan. Tinatanggap kita bilang sarili kong tagapagligtas at Panginoon ng aking buhay. Ako po ay naniniwala na ikaw ay napaako sa krus dahil sa aking kasalanan. Namatay, subalit nabuhay na maguli upang bigyan ako ng bagong buhay at pag-asa sa buhay na walang hanggan. Sabihin mo, Lord, I thank you for saving my soul. This I pray in Jesus' name. Amen.
If you prayed that prayer, we believe you got born again. Please let us know by texting 0968-228-9177. That's 0968-228-9177. Or send us an email to dwbl@wordofhope.ph or follow us on Facebook. You may also visit our website, www.wordofhope.ph. That's www.wordofhope.ph.
Hi there, this is Bishop David Sobrepeña. Thank you for listening to A Word of Hope here on 1242 DWBL Mondays through Fridays at 5:30 to 6 a.m. and 8 to 8:30 p.m. I'm here to ask you for a small favor. I'd love to know if you listen to this program. And if so, what do you think of it? You may text us through 0968-228-9177 or send us an email to dwbl@wordofhope.ph. Thank you, and God bless you.
Lost the top-rated music station.